Det er en klok som dette nå da.
Skal jeg si noe klok?
Ja, den er klok.
Så vi i gang med den store turen. Akkurat omkommet Sør-Afrika flight i morgen, så den bedre middag.
Ok.
Så, da jeg fremme i Sør-Afrika. Dette min vy fra hotellet i Pretoria. En lummig park, derfor hva heter den nå da? Utsikten, ganske begrenset. Her nede ligger staden noen sted. Jeg har akkurat hatt et ganske kraftig fordenvær, derfor vel sikten noen som er begrenset. Dette mitt rom. Det vel ikke all verdens. Egentlig ikke dette med hotell, det et konferansesenter som vi på. Og det stengt i helgen egentlig. Så middagen vi får i dag, den vel ikke så fantastisk for å si det sånn da. Men endelig så har jeg fått et rom med min fantastiske vifte. Burt Lancaster eller hva det nå heter. Nei, det er ikke han jeg tenker på. Nå kommer jeg ikke på, men alle andre vet hvem jeg mener. Her er jeg på baksiden. Her er det som er gangen mellom alle bygninger. Det er masse bygninger her. Det er for at vi skal kunne gå og ta skode fra sted.
The park. We are here at Qua Mauritani. We're gonna make our way up this road here. I thought we would see some lions here, but the rangers informed me there's a water hole there. They saw some lions yesterday and this afternoon and this morning. So we're gonna make our way up there as soon as possible. Hopefully they'll still be there, because when we get there it will be quite warm. So we're gonna do most of this area round, and this is where we're gonna leave again. This is Bakaboom Gate. We will have lunch. City, so we've got a big area, but to get into these northern areas is so big and vast. You'll see that unfortunately there's some buffalo in this area here, but we won't be able to make it. But hopefully we'll see quite a lot here at the dam. There's some beautiful lookout points there, and a lot of ample time to take. Leopards use it as a delicacy, and you see that once they run, the tail goes up very quickly. But they're a fierce animal, because the top jaw has got a very strong, curved, big teeth, and then the bottom one is actually the dangerous one. It's like a knife that sits right next to it. And they've actually been said that they've seen leopards being killed by these, defending their young ones. Because it's like a knife, if they hit the leopard correctly in the stomach, they can rip them right open, kill them. But when they feed, they will go down onto their haunches. They use a strong beak and the teeth to burrow into the ground, because they eat the roots. And that one is then usually when they become older. That's when you find that they'll try when they get old, and quite a lot. sometimes some animals do get drunk from it. Elephants like it especially, and also baboons. And if you ever drink the Amarula liqueur, it's very much the same taste that you'll have. A lot of people make mampur from it as well. They will just distill it and make the potent stuff. You cross the water, you see there's quite a lot of animals on the other side. Some more blue wildebeest. The white belly of the distinct marking, and then also the horns are very distinct. Curved to the middle, to the inside. Now getting back to somebody asking about the intelligence of animals, and that animal's got the brain the size of a golf ball. But I think that for the last 300 million years, they haven't really changed much, and they've been able to survive. So I think it says quite a lot for them. You get quite a lot of still attacks when native people go wash their washing, and they just get taken by crocodiles quite often.
Really. He thinks he's a camel.
You get the two types. The blue wildebeest is much bigger than the black wildebeest, and the horn.
What is Romain doing?
Oh, then!
Studying the environment.
I should pull out the whole thing.
Yeah, Volky.
I'll tell you a story.
Yeah,
till Afrika. Lördag eftermiddag. Det är mycket bad, inga massor sol.